Hi, I'm Chip Wood. If you self-produce your voiceover and do all of your post-production, occasionally a client will ask you to add a music background to your voiceover. In the industry, this is called a music bed. Let's look at how to do that.
In the first track, we have the dry voiceover for a one-minute spot. Select an open track, and you can drag a music file such as an MP3, WAV, or AIFF from the desktop into the track. Or if your file is in your music library, click this Media Browser or hit F, Media, Music, scroll to the file you'd like, and drag and drop. A music bed will begin with either a fade-in or, like this one, a cold start. We'll begin by cropping this dead space and bringing the track to the zero mark. Now, let's find the best place for the voiceover to begin, which will be the downbeat after the drum fill. Keeping the cursor at that point, let's adjust the vocal to begin at that spot. Let's see how those line up. That's a good starting point, but the music bed is too loud. They're both set here at 0 decibels, and you want to adjust the music bed volume rather than the voiceover. Let's bring it down to, say, 9.6. Let's see how that works. That's a pretty good balance. You don't want the music bed to distract from the voiceover. This is a one-minute commercial spot, and we've pushed our voiceover back a little. Let's go to the one-minute mark and put a cursor there. I'm going to zoom in a little, Command Arrow Right, so that we have room to build a fade-out. Now select the music track and hit A, which will show automation. Click on the track to reveal the volume bar. The voiceover ends right here, so click to place a marker on the volume bar, and since this is the 1 minute mark, click, then click again and drag all the way down. Let's go back and check this edit. Hit A again to set this, and now you have your cold start and a fade out. Now click the cycle button. Let's zoom out a little. And we'll drag the cursor to the 1 minute mark. Now go to Share, Export Song to Disk, Commercial, Export to Desktop. I've selected MP3 and click Export Cycle Area. Now let's do a fade in on this clipped bed because we can't start with that. Hit A, click in the track. We'll zoom in. Let's place the cursor at the beginning of the voiceover. Put a marker on the volume bar to match, and drag the first marker down. Check the fade. This is Alex. Hit A. Zoom out. Now I'll show you how to edit a track to create a cold start. I have to do this occasionally when a client requests that the music begin at a specific point in the track. I'm going to drag in a bed that has a musical structure that builds as it progresses. Yikes, that's too loud. Let's bring this down to 18. Moving ahead to bar 13, it adds piano and drums. And that's where we want to start. We'll drag delete, select delete, and drag this to the beginning. Now we'll do some precision trimming. Add the voice.
This is Alex.
Tighten the vocal entrance. Bring this up.
This is Alex.
And that's it. Ducking is a technique that briefly lowers the volume of the music when the voice needs to be emphasized, and we're going to select a phrase here in the middle as an example. Let's zoom in, hit A, click track, and we'll begin placing adjustment markers at the beginning and the end of the phrase. In the middle, click, hold, and drag down, and that lowers the music during that sentence.
If you find this tutorial helpful, please subscribe and take a look at the other tutorials for more helpful hints on post-production in VoiceOver. Thanks for watching.